Jennifer Palmieri, thanks for joining us. Last time we talked to you, you said you thought about coming on the show. You didn't really want to because you thought it was going to be mean and set you up. But you've got this book. So I'm not going to be mean and set you up. I want to ask about the book that you just wrote.
Yes, I decided that, you know, like I said, I like you, Tucker. I think you were a smart guy. And I enjoy talking to you.
So what's the book about?
So the book is about, I wrote it, I wanted to be consciously forward-looking. I wanted to be consciously optimistic. So I said, I want to write, not a book about the campaign, I want to write a book of advice about, based on, I had two experiences. What I learned watching a woman running for president and the obstacles that I think still exist for women, particularly women in positions of power. And then also, you know, I've been a woman working in politics for a couple of decades, very high levels in the White House, and I learned a lot about lessons that I think help other women about, you know, sometimes women feel inhibited about speaking their mind or seeking a higher position. And I feel like I learned a lot that I could share with other women. But what I really had in my mind were young women entering the workforce now. And I wrote it as a letter to the first woman president because I wanted everyone reading it to believe that's what they could be.
So it's not, strictly speaking, a political book.
It's really not a political book at all.
So yeah. As you assess the obstacles to women rising either in politics or in business or in any field.
Right.
Was it exclusively men? Was it other women? Was it
a
combination?
I did not go into Hillary's campaign thinking that it was a big deal to elect the first woman president or that it was going to be hard, okay? I feel like I've had a great career. I've had men and women both that supported me, great mentors. And I thought we had equality. And then after the campaign, I realized when you step back from human history and think about a woman in charge, it's a radical thing. It's only been 100 years since women had the right to vote. It's only been 100 years since women have been in the workplace. And when you look at the history of the workplace, going back hundreds of years, it's still a big deal. The workplace was built by men, and it was, there's customs that, that were built by them, for them, to suit how they interact. And I felt like with Hillary's generation, with that baby boomer generation, women that started work in the 1960s, 1970s, they had to prove that they could do the job just as well as a man could, in the same way, right? They didn't need special allowances. They were strong, they were tough, they could do it. And they did. And I feel like that's what Hillary did when we ran her for president. We proved she could do the job just as a man would, right? And you're like, what does that wrap her up, first of all? But second, I think now we don't have to. I could do the job just as well as a man, but I don't want to. I want to do it the way I do it, the way I want to do it. And there is, I think we believe women are, good in the workplace. They've had a ton of opportunity, but there is a question about women and ambition that exists. When Hillary was a senator, right? She was really popular. People liked her a lot in that job. When she was Secretary of State, she was really popular. People liked her in that job. When she was a candidate for Senate, she wasn't as popular. It's true for other women candidates.
And I've heard this, and I'm sure there's some truth at the bottom of it, but there are also a lot of other things going on, like the country changed, the middle class died, life expectancy went down.
I didn't say this is why she lost. Even if she won, even if she had won, I think I might not have seen this as clearly what these obstacles still are, but they would have existed.
But this, you said this wasn't a political book. I mean, it is confusing, and look, I'm.
There's a lot, yeah.
That I don't understand a lot about this. But in order for this to be a clean theory, you have to explain why so many women voted against her.
That's not, I don't think there's anything about how we think about women and ambition that's a clear theory.
That's right.
Now.
No, that's totally fair.
Sincere about this.
It is
a vexing thing. And let me explain one particular instance that I think sheds a light. I went and watched interviews about Hillary from the 92 campaign, okay? 92. And there were, what do you think, man on the street, women on the street interviews, right? Because, you know, we're all just, we didn't make this world well. We all inherited it and its traditions and views. So it's gender biased isn't gender biased. And what do you think of Bill Clinton's wife, right? They asked man on the street, women on the street. You know, there's something about her I just don't like. There's something about her I just don't trust. And it wasn't mean-spirited, and it wasn't, they weren't being overtly sexist, and they didn't have something against her. She vexed them. She confounded them. And I think it is because she has always been a woman who was stepping out of roles that women traditionally have. So when she was a college student and she gave her commencement speech and she stood on the stage and she challenged the senator that introduced her, she ended up on the cover of Life magazine. She was a female face of the baby boomer generation, right? Then the next time you saw her, although you did know she was the same person, she was Bill Clinton's wife, who wouldn't change her name, who made more money than him, who worked outside of the home.
I'm sorry. And this is self-serving. I've let you speak at great length, but
it's
she's consistently attacked other women.
That is false.
The other day she said that white women voted against me because their husbands and their sons told them to. I can't imagine anything more patronizing, more disgusting to say about
more
women.
Disgusting.
No, like my wife. Mm-hmm. Say something like that, like if a man had said that, well, they just, white women did this because they were bossed around by men.
So you didn't let me, but my point is, I think, you know, and it's not just Hillary that they say this about.
Yes.
Elizabeth Warren, there's something about her I just don't like. Kirsten Gillibrand, there's something about her I just don't like. Kamala Harris, there's something about her I just don't like. And again, this is why I think it is worth examining, because we need to understand what's at the root of it.
But what if there's something about Mitt Romney I just don't like, which is true?
But you all, this network doesn't spend hours upon hours.
Oh, I have.
Hours. No,
there are a lot, all kinds of men there's something about I just don't like. I talked to three of them tonight.
I believe that, but, you know, this network has invested decades in tearing down Hillary Clinton. It has.
Well, a lot of people who work here disagree with her, but that doesn't mean they dislike all women.
I didn't say that at all. That's the point. The point is that I think this is something we should look at because it affects. I don't think it's about gender.
About gender. And just for the record, let me just ask you one last thing.
I said it's not about gender, meaning it's not. I'm not saying that men only think one way and women only think one way. I'm saying we as a society, because it is still new, historically speaking, for women to be working in politics and I'm talking historically speaking, right? Hundreds and hundreds. Do you believe that the hatred that exists for Hillary Clinton is rational? Do you think that she is deserving? Do you think that Hillary Clinton has done so much in her life that she is deserving of the hatred? Does it not strike you as if something's amiss there?
I don't know. I marvel at how much I'm disliked sometimes, I'll be honest with you.
My friend, are not disliked the way Hillary Clinton is.
I will say this, which I think is actually interesting, and you can speak to it. You've been in Democratic politics for more than 20 years. You worked for Leon Panetta and John Edwards and Bill Clinton.
Yeah.
You worked for Hillary Clinton. All of those people, while liberal maybe for the time, by today's standards, are conservative Democrats. I mean, let's be honest.
The country has moved.
That's really my question. So Hillary Clinton could never run for any office on her husband's 1992 platform. True. Democrat could.
No, the country has changed since 1992. The country is not dealing with the same problems it's dealing with since 1992. It's a very different thing. But that is not what my book is about. What my book is about is recognizing that there are still problems, there are still obstacles that stand in the way, some which women, some which we have inherited, some which live in, you know, my own mind in terms of, you know, inhibitions I feel about being able to speak my mind, or if I say this, am I going to be attacked? And what I am doing in the book is saying, don't worry so much about whether or not you think your your perspective matters. Let me promise you that it does. Let me promise you, you have something interesting to say. Let me promise you, if you're a woman at a table and there's mostly men around you, your perspective is more important, not less. Like, those are the lessons that I had to learn in working in a White House.
Jennifer Palmieri, thank you for that.
Thank you, Tucker.